Well, we are back here, and I'm with Chloe, and we were just watching the wonderful images of Julian landing on the ground. Chloe, what a moment.
It unbelievable moment, and actually listening, watching you receive that news and your response to it, and how much this means to the people that have been with Julian since the very beginning, and those of us like me that have joined the campaign to fight for Julian. What that moment was to me is the world will never be the same again. Something shifted, and to see that hug with Stella, to see his fists in the air, it's just one of the greatest things I've ever seen.
It's truly an amazing moment, and we just heard from Roger Waters, and I was recalling when he was playing "Wish You Were Here" outside Priti Patel's office here in London. I will not go into any details on Priti Patel. Let's forget her. Let's forget the past struggle for the moment, and just enjoy that feeling that is flowing basically through our veins at the moment. At least that's why how I feel. It's such
Yes.
a tremendous moment of joy to finally be there. And my God, and as Roger said, you know, that symbol of love and strength in love, because what Stella has been going through and the fight is that she's put up in this immense struggle. It's absolutely superhuman, and she deserves so much praise for that work she's done at fighting for her husband. It is just an unbelievable ending to this saga to be finally at this moment, and what individuals that we have here for the future struggles. But of course, my God, I hope they need to they take a breath, a deep breath, enjoy a
Yes.
break.
Yes. I mean, he could not have found himself a better life partner than Stella. He could not have found somebody that understood every detail of his case, from the legal to the political to the global to the journalistic to the human rights, every single level of the situation against Julian, she understands in her blood. And I would extend that, Kristinn, I would extend that to you and your commitment. And I'm sorry, I'm really emotional, but I would extend it to you and how you've operated over these past decade and a half, and the solidarity and the support and the direction from you. And Julian, despite in many respects having the worst treatment that any human could have, has got the greatest group of advocates on this planet. And I just pay absolute tribute to yourself, to Joseph Farrell, to Stella, to people in Valholland, to many other people I can't mention and cannot think of right now who have been there and have fought for Julian from morning till night and in between. And it's been the honor of my life to work in this campaign and to finish it on a high, which you just don't expect. You just don't expect that you get what you want. And I feel like this will bleed into every campaign that's currently in action around the world. This will give people the hope that they need to keep fighting. You can make the change that you need. And that's what Julian has done. And that's what you have done, and Stella, and everybody else. It's quite phenomenal.
Well, thank you for the kind words, Chloe. But I mean, let's go out there. Let's go out there and tell people you can do it. You can move mountains. This is, we
Yes.
saw a mountain just me being moved. You know, I will not, when I reflect back to my mind to 2019, I was discussing this with Stella this morning. When, I mean, the treatment of Julian in the mainstream media, the smearing, the absolute dehumanization that had taken place over the past those previous years was just it was astonishing. You almost lost faith in the human race. But I mean, there were always good people there, and they grew in numbers, and unfortunately some have gone, and we need to have a remembrance of their role. Roger mentioned John Pilger, who has passed, a great man. Daniel Ellsberg is very supportive. Vivian Westwood, Gavin McFadden, they all played a huge role in it.
Yes.
And, you know, so many people who took part in this fight and understood the gravity of the situation, understood the importance, and had gone through so much that they knew that you could actually do something and you had a duty. And from my perspective, if I allow myself to be personal, this is just, it has been a privilege to take part in this project. It was a privilege when I joined in 2010 in the most amazing, spectacular journalistic feats. I would never have dreamed as a journalist from a small country in the North Atlantic to end up in this whirlwind of first the tremendous stories, the collateral murder video, going to Baghdad, meet the victims there and the relatives of those who were killed, and through being part of those this project of these huge stories, and then have to change sort of a role and go into the fight for the freedom of Julian. So it's been a roller coaster, but what a journey and what a privilege to be a part of it.